In this video, we'll be seeing how to play a video using Hls JS. This is the demo of what we are going to do in this video. Here on the network tab, you can see a file named video.m3u8. And if you click this, go to the response section and you can see three quality options for the video. That is 480, 720 and 1080. Now, these are the three qualities that we have for the video. And Hls JS will automatically choose the quality according to the network and the resolution of the screen. Now, if you play this, you can see the quality will change automatically. First of all, we have to convert the video file, that is the .mp4 file, to a format that is supported by Hls. So here we are going to convert it to .m3u8. For that, I have created a project and uploaded it to this server. You can check the link. I will give it on the description. This makes the task of converting the video file to Hls supported format easy. You simply have to click a button and it will convert the file automatically. You also have a progress bar that will show the percentage of the task. So you can download it from here. I will give the link in the description. I have downloaded it and placed it inside XAMPP htdocs. And inside that, I have extracted the zip file and kept it here. So if you don't have XAMPP, install the latest version of XAMPP. You have to make sure you have the PHP 8.1 and above. Now, I have installed the latest version of XAMPP. You can see here. Start the XAMPP Apache. Now you can go to localhost slash the folder name. So let's go to localhost slash the folder name. So our project has loaded. Now if you click this convert mp4 to m3u8, it will start working because I have given a demo mp4 file inside the folder. So it will start working automatically. Before that, you have to change the MP4 file to the video that you need. So let's open this inside a VS Code. So I have opened this inside VS Code. You can see the file index.html and hlscreate.php. Now here you can see you have to change the video file here. Here I have given the video inside video folder video.mp4. So you can see that inside the video, video.mp4, and this is the video. Okay, now we are going to convert this video. So, and you can choose the quality options here. Here I have given the list of qualities. So, and here you have to choose the needed quality options. I have chosen three quality options, that is 480, 720 and 1080p. So you can add more from this list. Now this is the output file. I have given it the folder output. Then the file name is video.m3u8. Don't change the video extension. Keep it same. You can change the video name. Okay, that's all. Now let's try running this. You can change the video here. I'm not changing it. So let's click convert mp4 to M3U8. Now you can see the progress bar has started moving. If your progress bar is not moving, simply go to the network tab. You can see the log file has been loading continuously. So click this and check the response part. If it is continuously showing zero, that means the log file has been cached. So simply open this inside a new tab and reload this. And then you can check the progress again. That this happens because of the caching of that file. So that's all. But the task continues behind the background. Just the progress bar doesn't show up. That's all. So we have converted the file properly. And you can see the conversion has completed 100%. Now go to the folder. You can see the folder output. Inside that, you are having so many files. Let's view it. Okay. You can see so many files has been created from that single video file. Okay, now this is our main file. Let's go to VS Code. Here you can see the output. Now this is the file. Now you can see we are having three video qualities as we have shown before, and here you can see the chunks of videos. See, we are having four chunks for the 480p video, and four for the 720, and for the 1080. So let's try running this. We have converted the video file. Now we have to copy this chunks and paste it to our assets folder inside the next project assets folder. Now let's select all the files. You need all the files. Okay, now you can see I have created a new project. Now this is for the player, so we'll be playing this chunks of video here. Okay, I have pasted all the videos inside the assets slash videos. You can see this. Okay, hope you understand. Now I am having the index.html file on the root. Now we have to add the HLS JS library. So go to the browser. I will give the link for this library in the description. Scroll down and you can see the JavaScript. Copy this. You can copy it from here to here. Okay. Now paste it here. You can remove this comment. Now close the script tag. So here you can see a test URL has been given. You have to change it to the assets slash videos slash video.m3u8. This is the file. Okay. So now we have changed the video URL. Now I'll explain the code. Here you can see we have added the JavaScript library for HLSJS. Here we are having a video tag with the ID video. We have to give the controls also. So controls. And you can also specify a width for this. Okay, that's all. Now we have added the video tag. Here inside the script tag, you can see that we are fetching the element by ID. That is video. ID is video. Now you are storing it inside the variable video. Here on the video SRC, we are having the link to the video file. That is the converted video file. Okay. And inside this if condition, you can see if HLS is supported. If HLS is supported, this will run. Okay. If not, you can add an else part and load, maybe load .mp4 video file or etc. So we are not going to do that. We are only using HLS. So you can see HLS. We are creating a new variable for the HLS class. And we are loading the source. Now this is the URL of the video. Now we are attaching it to the video element. This is the variable of the video element. We are attaching the media to the video element. That's all. And we have completed the implementation. Now let's run this. So here you can see we have opened this inside the browser. When you play this, you can see the video has been playing. You can see that the quality of the video changes according to the network. Okay. And the resolution of the screen also. So you can see the download option is not there. And if you check the network tab, let's refresh this page. You can see the chunks of videos are loading. See? Now, if you are having a very long video, you can see this properly. You can see the chunks loading one by one, one after another, slowly like that. Since we are having a very short video, it gets loaded very quickly. That's all. That's how Hls JS plays the video. This makes it smooth and faster. So hope you understand how to implement this. If you are having any doubt, you can leave a comment. I will definitely respond to all the comments. You can also join our community. We are having a great community. You can get response there for your doubts, etc. If you need the complete source code of this project, you can check the URL. I will give this URL in the description. Here you can see the video player option. I have created a video player which looks like this. I will show you the images. See, I have created a video player, given it a skin design, etc. And also added a quality option. Okay, quality switch option also. I will explain this in next video, but this source code is having that already implemented. If you want, you can download this. Okay, now this is the one which you need to convert the video file. Okay, you can download this to convert it. This is this one. Okay, this is the demo of this one. I will give all the links for this in the description. You can download it now. Now that's all. I hope you understand how to implement this. So let's see you on the next one.